Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned all the ni'mas of Ramadan, all the barakahs of Ramadan, and how Allah jalla wa ala's mercy descends in dunya. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions how Jannah is decorated. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talks about the hoods of Jannah. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions how the angels of Allah jalla wa ala, they descend. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, all are forgiven. All are forgiven, but four. And who are the four people? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, one who is addicted to wine. The first one, one who drinks sharab. One who is addicted to wine is someone who will not be forgiven. So this is important. If someone is addicted to wine, make tawbah in the month of Ramadan. Ask for Allah's forgiveness. Millions of people who deserve to be in hellfire, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they will all be forgiven in the month of Ramadan, but four people. One who is addicted to wine, and the second, the one who disobeys his parents. This is very important. Young people in the month of Ramadan, they may recite Quran, they may do ibadah, they may go and read Tarawih, they may act upon other ahkam of Sharia, but they disobey their parents. Remember that. Everything will be rejected. Everything will be thrown back at you on the day of judgment if you disobey your parents. Some people in their own household, you know, arm someone pious. I have taqwa, I have ibadat. My father doesn't understand anything. My mother doesn't understand anything. They are jahils. They have no knowledge. I am a Sufi. I'm a pure person. Remember, your tasawwuf is not greater than the tasawwuf of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Your knowledge is not greater than the knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is the beloved of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who said this. One who disobeys his parents, millions who deserve Jahannam will be forgiven, but the one who disobeys his parents will not be forgiven in the month of Ramadan. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the one who breaks ties from close relatives, creates arguments, nafrat, even if it is your close relative, even if it is his fault, even if he's wrong. This is a training for the month of Ramadan. If you want to benefit from this month of Ramadan, and if you want to attain taqwa in the month of Ramadan, the first thing we must do is go to our relatives, those who have distanced themselves from us, ask them for forgiveness, seek forgiveness. Say, I've got too many sins, I have too many gunas, I can't take it, I need to ask Allah for forgiveness. I read the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the wrath of Allah jalla wa ala. I cannot bear the fire of this dunya. The intensity of the fire of this dunya is unbearable. What about the one, the intensity of which is 70 times worse than the one we have in this dunya? How will I bear that? It's impossible. Talk about it and say that, remember, if we die in this state, we will not be forgiven. So I ask for forgiveness. I ask for forgiveness. Make niyyah, brothers and sisters in Islam. Make niyyah, all of us. That is something that we will work on, inshallah. We will go to our relatives. We will ask them for forgiveness. We will beg them for forgiveness. We make niyyah, inshallah, in the month of Ramadan, inshallah. And remember, before Ramadan, this should take place. And those of you to whom this message will be conveyed in Ramadan, the moment you listen to this message, implement it immediately. Sitting in your own house, I read so much Quran, I do so much ibadah, I read the Tarawih, I have been fasting, but so and so is bad, so and so is evil. They are creating nafra, they are creating hatred, they are evil people, they are bad people. Remember, if there is no razi between you and your relatives, all your ibadat will be rejected. Muhammad said this. The best of creation is saying this. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And look at the fourth point. Fourth point is also about this. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that those who have ill will against people will break relationship. Meaning those who have intention of harming people, those who break relationship,